What's up, everybody? It's your boy Wesley here with another video, and today we're talking about what's in my 2019 camera bag.
I've been having dreams, splashing in the summer street, tripping, I fall in. I wanted it to happen. My body turns to ice, crushing weight of paradise. Solid block of gold, lying in the cold. I feel right.
So first and foremost, we got a new bag. The Acuvar? Let me tell you about this bag. So, for those of you who have seen me with my old bag, pause. If you haven't seen my old bag, it would be in the card, one of those directions. But it was this. One strap, tiny bag, not that many compartments. I was very, very excited when I first got this. But now, yeah, it's gone. All right. So that's that, a little bit of backstory about that. But let's hop into this new bag for 2019. And woo! I've been in love with this bag ever since I first got it. Let's start with the outside of the bag. First and foremost, I have my flexi bendy tripod, which I probably will eventually take off, because this one is pretty much gone, but it's just in case of the event that I need a tripod or I need to set it up somewhere. Then we're gonna move around to the front here. I always keep this little watch on here at all times, wherefore if I ever forget my Apple Watch or the battery dies on the Apple Watch, then hey, still got that one. Plenty of straps to hold stuff down or keep it nice and tight. So first compartment, you have the card reader. This was a $10 card reader from Walmart, which I honestly love this one a lot more than the one that I had previously. It says it takes 72 cards, but I'm not seeing the 72 cards. I really just use it for my SD cards and my micro SD cards. Next, we have the power bank by PNY. It's fully charged right now. I don't really think y'all can see them blue lights. But this is for my phone majority of the time. Sometimes iPad. My phone dies a lot faster than my iPad does. Thirdly, for this pouch, we have the USB to Lightning, which would go for either my iPad or my iPhone. Any footage that I needed to upload or photos that I've taken that I just want to edit on my iPhone, then I would literally just use this cable right here, which is what that is for. Second compartment on the front. Let's see, we got a dig down here. We have my SD card holders. It can hold CFast cards, but unfortunately I don't have a camera that has a CFast card slot or CFast cards, period. A backup USB with important documents on the front of that. Hand sanitizer, I have to have this. That's it. Yeah. Now we're up to our first major compartment. Yeah, just as I thought. There's nothing in there right now, but for me, what I keep in there would be my iPad 6th generation 9.7 with my Apple Pencil. Those are what stay in this compartment. At this point, I no longer carry my laptop with me. I would only carry my iPad, and that's it. Whoop. Now we are up to our final compartment. Unfortunately, unlike everybody else's backpacks, I don't have the money or the funds to get a backpack that opens towards the back. So for now, I have to stick with mine that opens to the front. Two main compartments. I keep another set of hand sanitizer, but this is the Smell Good hand sanitizer. And the front here came from Bath & Body Works. Oh yeah. Just that. So we have the 70-300 lens, manual focus only, no autofocus. Have to have this one in the bag, of course, which has its own corner right there. Then we have the Yongnuo digital 50mm Nikon F mounts. Other one that I have to have. I have my own Walmart flash. Pretty simple stuff. There really is no full breakdown to everything that is in here. Nikon D3100. I did have a battery grip on here for y'all that remember in the last video. But I no longer keep that battery grip on here. I don't. Mainly because it's too tall for the camera bag itself. And it's just time for a change. I don't really want it on there anymore. Next, we have the Nikon P77000. This one is my main vlog for the flip screen. Yeah, that's that one. Goes right beside the Nikon D3100. Right beside that, we have my battery charger for both the Nikon D3100 and the Nikon P77000, which they both take the same battery, which would be the Nikon ENEL 14 battery, if I said that correctly. Approximately, I have three of those, one, two, and a third one in one of the cameras. Yeah, I literally just keep those right there, not bothering anybody. First aid kit, Band-Aid, Band-Aids, wipes, and gauze. Nice. Ibuprofen, of course, need that at all given motherfucking times. Photographer's emergency pouch. This is inspired truly and deeply by Peter McKinnon. This is actually, I followed his exactly. I won't say to the T, but yeah. That's that compartment. Now this one did come with one more feature, which would be the water resistant pouch, which I'm really not gonna fully pull out, but it's at the bottom there just in case I ever got caught in the rain during a photo shoot or during around water or anything like that. That's where that is. Two pouches on the side. Which, when traveling, I would keep my 1 terabyte Seagate hard drive on this side. And then on this side, I really don't keep anything. Nothing at all. Another thing that I keep on me that is not in my camera bag, but I do keep, would have to be my iPhone 7 Plus. That right there, which also is on the cell phone holster mount. Those two things right there are mainly for my slow-mos and my time-lapse. If y'all didn't know that iPhone can do time-lapse, yes, they can do time-lapse at 120 frames per second. Yeah, and that's that. But that there is the camera bag that I have for 2019. I thank y'all so much for watching. Please hit that subscribe button one time. Turn on that bell to be notified whenever I post up a new video. Like I said in my previous video as well. Cannot stress that enough. Previous videos, go watch those. Thank y'all for watching. See y'all in the next one. Peace.